Today on BRStv, we're talking calcium reactors and magnesium. Hi, I'm RT, one of your hosts of BRStv, with another episode of 52 FAQs, where each week we answer your frequently asked questions from our popular 52 Weeks of Reefing series. This week we're answering Alex De Michieli's question from week 32. If you're dissolving old coral pieces in a calcium reactor, isn't it also going to dissolve mag as well? Why do you need to add the extra mag? Good question. As a quick refresher, calcium reactors dissolve media that's often derived from old coral skeletons or fossils and essentially adds all the ions, nutrients, and elements into the tank. In addition to the calcium-based reactor media, a lot of reefers choose to run products like Zeomag, Remag, and Neomag to automate the addition of magnesium into their aquarium, as these products dissolve inside the calcium reactor as well. In theory, you'd think that since the calcium reactor media melts the entire fossilized coral pieces into the individual elements or ions, it would release everything you need to grow a healthy coral and you wouldn't need to add additional elements to the water. However, there's a little bit more to it than that. First, magnesium is one of the most abundant elements in seawater and is used by many processes, creatures, and reactions in the ocean as well as your tank. So the magnesium uptake by your corals likely is only a portion of what is truly being consumed in the tank and what will ultimately need to be replaced. Second, due to the century the media was formed, the type of material, and the collection sites, all the calcium reactor medias are slightly different, and while most have balanced calcium and alkalinity, a majority of them are magnesium deficient. The net result of these two factors is your magnesium levels will likely drop over time without some type of additional supplementation. One of the most important functions of magnesium is that it forms a buffer between calcium and alkalinity, two elements that have a natural affinity to bind to one another. Maintaining an elevated magnesium level is key to preventing precipitation events in your tank. It will help keep your calcium and alkalinity levels balanced and right where they need to be for the best growth. Maintaining magnesium with your calcium reactor can be done with simple additives like magnesium chloride, magnesium sulfate, or even better, an optimized mix like the one we've put together specifically for calcium reactors. More or less, dissolve it in water to make a gallon of solution and use the Reef calculator to calculate your dose. This is my personal preference because it's more flexible and you can use it to make larger adjustments as well as smaller maintenance doses. That being said, most reefers who run calcium reactors prefer to mix in magnesium carbonate-based medias with their standard reactor media because it's a lower maintenance and more automated solution. The most popular probably being Zeomag, and the manufacturer recommends mixing up to 30% Zeomag with your mix. Keep in mind that these medias are designed to dissolve slowly and are best used to make small continuous additions to keep the magnesium levels stable and not to make big adjustments. It's likely, even with the magnesium reactor media, you'll need a liquid additive to make larger corrections or adjustments from time to time. With any luck, we've helped answer some questions for those who were curious about magnesium supplementation and calcium reactors. If it was helpful, let us know with a quick thumbs up, and if you're looking for a more complete look at calcium reactors, this FAQ was taken from week 30. Calcium reactor on the BRS160, you decide. If you have any questions or tips for either us or the BRS community, let us know in the comments area down below. In today's poll, we're asking all of you your preferred method for calcium reactor magnesium supplementation, so please vote and check out the results to see what others are doing. I'll see you in the next BRS 52 FAQ, where we answer social phobians question from week 5. If I'm to drill a 40-gallon breeder, what overflow should I use, what bulkhead, and how wide should I drill the glass for the hole?